Hey guys, what's up? Hope everybody's doing good out there today, and really appreciate you taking a little bit of your day out to watch the video. Much appreciated. And I've been a busy day around here. Been spending most of the day working on Fish the Moment lake map breakdowns, and getting ready tomorrow. Johnny and I are going to have another on the water challenge that's going to be coming up on Fish the Moment YouTube channel. We're going to do a topwater challenge tomorrow on Table Rock Lake, so keep you updated on that. And been spending time arguing with or blocking and fighting with internet trolls, and working out. I started a new workout routine. It's been killing me 5 days a week. So hopefully that'll pay off, but I've really been hitting it hard in the gym this week, and gonna keep on that to come moving forward. But today's video, I wanna talk about something really gonna help you guys out, specifically as we get later into summer. You know, we're into July now. So the tip that I'm going to give you today is really going to be good in as July gets on towards the mid end part of July into August and also into September. And that is really understanding why specifically when you're targeting shallower fish in the summertime that you need to make a switch away from the larger, like if you're using a larger type square bill crankbait like this Megabass S crank, to a smaller crankbait. This is a Megabass Z2 crankbait. You can see the size comparisons a little bit. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about why this is critical as far as to help you get more bites, specifically in shallow water summer situations. And if you guys are interested in any of this stuff I'm talking about, I'll include the Baitworks link. If you guys wanna use that link, you know, it's a really good way to support the channel here. We get a small percentage of that sale and everything. Okay, so let's get into this a little bit. I love shallow water summertime cranking. It's one of my favorite ways to catch them. It's a great option if you don't like to fish out off the bank deep, because there's always a population of fish that's going to live shallow in any man-made impoundment. I don't care where it is. You put a big tournament on a man-made impoundment in the middle of the summertime, and yeah, there may be 7 or 8 guys that finish in the top 10 that fish deep out off the bank, but there's always going to be 1 or 2 guys that do good in the tournament, sometimes win fishing shallow in the summertime. So you can target shallow fish specifically. And to me, what happens is there's a little bit of a personality change in the bass as summer goes on. I've seen this over and over again as far as the mood of the fish and their desire to either chase a bait or not chase a bait, and the things that really trigger their strikes. And for me, what happens is once you get into July, that's when I'm thinking about a lot of shallow cranking. And that's when I go to my square bills like this. You know, fishing square bills normally in the most stained water I can find in the lake, around any rock or wood cover. It's a really good way to catch them. There's a lot of detail that goes in behind cranking square bills in the summertime that we'll talk about in some future videos. But specifically what I'm talking about here is the bait themselves. These baits, these larger square bills, they're gonna work really good. I like them, you know, right after the fish come off the beds, like from the time they come off the beds in May into June a little bit, into the post-spawn. I catch a lot of fish on these bigger square bill crankbaits, whether it be this Megabass 2.0, or if you're using the Strike King 2.5, or, you know, a Bagley Balsa B3, those larger square bills. But you'll notice as that water temperature gets hotter and it starts to get up into the mid-80s, and a lot of times the water starts falling a little bit, you still got stained water and you still got some isolated targets, wood or rock in the cover you're fishing, they get off those larger shallow run crankbaits more. And that's when I go to the smaller versions. The smaller crankbaits, the thing about them is a lot of people think, okay, if I go to a smaller crankbait, I'm gonna sacrifice quality. You don't, guys. If you go to a smaller crankbait in the heat of the summer, you're not sacrificing size. When I go to a smaller crankbait, like the Z2 crankbait, or if you use like a 200 Bandit, which is similar to this thing right here, you don't sacrifice size at all. The good fish will still hit these crankbaits, but you get a lot more bites on them than you do when you're fishing a square bill. So normally what I'll do is, like I said, square bill cranking, you know, it's designed for, you know, 4 foot in water and less, got the square lip on it, doesn't dive deep. But anytime you take these smaller crankbaits, you know, again, like the 200 Bandit, or the Z crank, or any bait in this type of category. This bait right here is designed to run like 4 to 6 feet deep on like 10 to 12 pound test line. I'll put this bait, you know, on 15 to 17 pound test line And I fish it, you know, 1 to 3 feet deep. I don't fish this bait deep. I'll take this thing, put it on heavier line, you know, keep my rod tip high, and I'll just sort of crawl it through that shallow water. And this thing, you know, the deeper lips kicking up that mud and that smaller profile of this crankbait in that super hot water, it just gets a lot more bites than the squarebills do. And the good thing about this is, like, one of the things I've noticed about when this bait excels is if you have isolated targets. Say you're in the back of the creek you're fishing, and you're fishing around, there could be some bank grass, there could be water willows, there could be an occasional lay down tree, there could be some stumps in the water, there could be an isolated dock. The time that this little crankbait excels is when you're on those isolated targets in super shallow water, the water's super hot, it's bright, it's sunny, and you make a bunch of casts. I mean, you don't hardly ever get a bite on these little crankbaits on the first cast around a key piece of cover. Most of the time, I'm casting 20, 30 times around the same piece of cover. Different angles, and the whole key is generating that strike when that bait comes past the cover at one particular angle. Because when you're dealing with shallow cover and you're dealing with stained water, like water visibility of anywhere between 6 inches, maybe to 15 inches like that, those bass are not gonna chase that lure very far. Even though the water's warm, the oxygen levels are not real high, the fish are not quite as aggressive, and you got to put that bait right in front of their mouth. And if you put a big crankbait like this in shallow, dirty, hot water, they won't bite it. I mean, you can catch them once in a while on it, but they will not bite it very good. But if you put this little downsized crankbait on it in that same situation and you come past it at the right angle, you know, they're gonna bite it, and the good ones will bite it. A couple of different tips I'll give you guys. Like I said, go to the heavier line. Color is real important too. Normally, if that water visibility is under 12 inches in visibility, I'm going with some type of a brighter perch pattern, chartreuse pattern. If it's in that zone of anywhere between 1 foot to 2 foot, then I'm using, you know, some of the shad patterns. I really like some type of a chrome finish. If you guys haven't tried a chrome finish in the summertime, it's a great color pattern for a smaller crankbait is chrome. And normally, if the water visibility is over 2 foot, I'm not cranking at all. I'm using some other type of technique. So give it a try, guys. As the summer goes on, as water gets hot, specifically more in towards the end of July, August, and September, downsize your crankbaits, fish them the same way you're fishing the squarebills, and I guarantee you're going to get more bites than you will if you stay with the squarebill. Squarebills get overfished. They're probably one of the most overfished lure categories out there. And I simply catch more fish on a deeper lipped crankbait in that shallow water as that summertime goes on. So give it a try, prove it to yourself. You know, I'm passing along some stuff that has allowed me to rip them on lakes all across the country this time of year. And I think it'll work for you guys too. So anyway, thanks for tuning in, guys. If you hadn't subscribed to the channel, please do so. We're getting close to getting 40,000 subscribers. I'm guessing it's probably going to be about another, I'm guessing, a week and a half. We'll be close to 40,000. And when we do that, we got a big giveaway coming. Cases of Bridge for Beef Jerky, Seaguar Fishing Line, Solar Bat Sunglasses. So all you have to do is subscribe to the channel to be eligible for that. Much appreciated. And we'll talk later. See you.